Okay, so I'm here again, downtown Barrie, beautiful downtown Barrie, and there is a car exhibition today, and I want to show you guys this. I mean, like the old timers, they are from the 50s, 60s, and even older. Look at those. I love that, actually. It's quite nice. You know, they used to have those suspension, which I totally love. You know, even if you're driving in a very treacherous terrain, these have very nice suspensions. Look at that engine. Oh my God. What is this supposed to do? Really don't know. Like, you're supposed to open this? Okay. Let's look at the interior. Nice. Anyways, the new cars have a much nicer interior and are more friendly when it comes to fuel consumption. These older cars, since fuel was cheap way back then due to petrodollar, and these are gas guzzlers. In any case, I mean, it's good to take a look at these older cars. And yeah, old engines. This one is like sports model of their time. You have those shift gears, no automatic, of course. And this one, oh my God, these have like really tough bodies, as you can see. Really tough. No ground clearance, almost no. Of course, way back, I don't think they had what's called air conditioners. I hardly think that any one of these cars do. Okay, this is one of the Buick. I think it's a Park Avenue. I had one of these when I came newly to Canada. Man, these are very comfortable cars, very comfortable. Actually, the one that I had was a bigger than this one. But yeah, these are really, they have nice suspension system. This Mustang, again a classic, I believe. Hey. And yeah, look at the inside. Nice leather seating. And oh yeah, look at this one. Oh, look at the timing belt. And this is again sports car. The paint, however, is new because way back then they didn't have paint like this. Now from the inside looks nice too. And so let me show you a ship. This one, oh, so nice. Look at those gadgets inside. Quite interesting. Ah, that's the engine. Nice and shiny, eh? Now look at this. This is a ship, okay? And they actually move like a ship. I wish I had one of these. You know, this one, when you drive, you feel like literally in a ship. You won't feel any kind of, you know, jerks while being on the road. Even over bumps, it will go so smoothly, you won't even notice. Again, these are gas guzzlers. Most likely this one is like 8 cylinders, I think. You have the old distributor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, exactly. 8 cylinders. And yeah, so huge. Like a ship, like a boat. Oh, I love that, man. That's really nice. So inside you have very comfortable seating here, see? Oh my God, this is so nice. You know, as a classic, I would keep one of those. And yeah, look at the trunk room, huge. Now this is an older one, probably from the 1930s. And it's a convertible. Of course, nothing electronics in here. You have to do it manually if you want to roll up the roof. Right, so that's what you have. And again, this one is another one. Nice. This one is a Falcon. You know, some of the people that likes those old timers, they keep the engine, you know, look at this, all shiny. And yeah, so even if you look inside, again, shift, no automatic transmission, of course, you have to shift. And there we go. That's a Pontiac. Again, sports model, relatively new, probably 70s, I guess. And then you have the seating here, looks nice. This from the 1970s, that's yours? Okay, I see. Okay. All right, what's this one? Experimental vehicle. So purchase Bridgeway Motors Wilson, 24 June 1968, production number, list price 4,868, family owned since new, brother to brother, never winter driven, color options, go package shift, blah blah blah. Wow, special duty handling, shocks, engine, 319 cubic inches V8 horsepower, 315 horsepower. Wow. Torque and all that stuff is quite good. Nice. Wow, above 300 horsepower this thing. That's the Ford fix or repair dailies.
Yes.
But in any case, way back then probably they used to make better ones. And huge tires, pickup truck. Nice. Okay, so let's take a look at here. This one is a GT500 Cobra. Yeah, these are relatively new ones, not really old timers, but you can see, I mean, has doesn't have an automatic transmission, but in any case, these are more used for kind of racing purpose. Again, this one is probably from the 1990s probably. I want to take you to older vehicles on this side, and you will find this to be very entertaining, because what we have here are cars that are probably 1920s or something, and someone was telling me there are real bullet holes here, so probably belong to Bonnie and Clyde or something. So look at this, there's zero ground clearance. I don't know what that is. Jack Daniel's old number 7 Tennessee Sour Mash Whiskey. So it runs on whiskey or something? I don't know. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think that's also an 8-cylinder engine. Yeah, it is, it is, V8. So V, because it's the arrangement of the pistons is in the form of V. And man, one thing I'm looking at, no ground clearance at all. It won't even make over bump. Yeah, so look at this from inside, really funny. Oh my goodness. Okay, so here,
you're putting it on your skin and you can taste it seconds later.
Yeah, that's not
again, Lone Maple Farms. Okay, that belongs to a farm or something. And yeah, interesting engine. Interior maybe not that great, but it's a kind of older pickup truck, as you can see here. This one is also pickup truck. Again, the engine size is kept very well, nice and shiny, except for the body. Looks like all rusted, but still, you know. Interesting. Okay. So you can see lots of people here. And yeah, again, it's a hot July. And very nice. I actually came with my friend's family. They came to visit me over for the weekend. They will stay most likely Monday. Tuesday we'll go to Innsville Beach as well. I'll record. And again, this, that's our nice downtown Barrie. People enjoying themselves. The road has been cordoned off so that there's no traffic and you can easily, you know, walk along on the street. And yeah, looking good. Now I have to get back to my friends. Yeah. I hope you guys like the car show, old-time car shows. Nice. Okay. All right, so this is one of the old pickup trucks. Again, very well kept. You can see clean engine, all of it. Interior. And even has a tilt. Oh. All right, these have bodies like a tank. See? Quite solid. Nice from the inside, right? Again, I believe leather seating. And so this is the inside of the engine. I mean, inside of the bonnet. Again, this I believe is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cylinders. Okay, I'm not supposed to touch the car, so I'll move away. So this one again is a pickup truck, classic old ones. Good. This one, it's a sedan. Oh, look at that Buick. Wow. As I told, I had one of those Buick Park Avenue cars. Very nice, very comfortable. These must be, you know, top of the line in that time. You even have you can see on the side there are some controls for the seating. And way back then, that was like super luxury. Yeah. So again, it's yeah, looks good. And I think there is a concert happening here. Look at that. Whoa. Funny stuff, eh? And we have some concert going on here. For that's the way I remember her, though. I'm wondering if she remembers me at all. Many times I've a few more cars. Oh wow, look at that. So if you're traveling to the North Country, looky here. Oh my god. You know what that is? Chevrolet. That's a drag racer. Look at those wheels. Oh my goodness. Okay. Huge wheels. And at the front, what do you have? Cycle wheels. That's kind of funny. Look at the size. So this one. Funny stuff, eh? So, where do you sit? You sit in here. See, you have those button kind of upshift, downshift, and of course only just one. This is used for drag racing. And yeah, what does it say? Do not touch. Okay, won't. Again, a ship, GTO, convertible, and really good. Yeah. You ride in them, you feel like riding in a boat. Another Ford. Hey, nice, it's here. Look at that. Again, looks all leather seating. Then look at this. Wow, again, very nice. See? The timing belt is really amazing. Very well kept, and I believe, again, this looks to me, is it a V8? Is it a V12? I can't tell really. Could be even 12 cylinders. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe V8. And again, this is two-seater with lots of boom boxes at the back, heavy woofers, again, pedal shifting, and kind of looks nice. What's that? Negative, positive, off, on. Wow. Okay. Good. Nice. So, you know, I was in Saudi Arabia, I was in Dubai, and for some reason you can't use your camera in most of the places. I don't know why, but you know, it's more freedom here. Like, no one is minding, you know, taking pictures or whatever. So again, older one, Ford V8, C4 automatic transmission, automatic, wow, Horton Mustang, Lincoln, four-wheel power, disc brakes, paint color, platinum metallic, air conditioning, power windows, remote door, wow, professionally upholstered, finished, custom vintages, all steel, ultra rare Canadian Mercury, professional built by Ron Box, nice. Yeah, it has been remade also, and I'm actually amazed. It's like a V8 engine. Of course, these are gas guzzlers, and I don't think that these are as efficient as today's engines. Today, engines actually give you more power with less number of cylinders. The Mercedes I have is a 4-cylinder, but it gives you excellent traction, like, not only traction, plus the pick and everything is so good. And yeah, but it's good to take a look at these old ones. Oh wow. Whoa, 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 I'm on fire. That's Bruce Springsteen's song, famous one. Whoa, 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 I'm on fire. Okay. Collector car appraisals. So these are collector cars basically, yeah. Some people keep them. You need a bit of space in order to, you know, to store these things. Usually, you know, you don't drive them during the winter months, of course. This is only just more for sure, but this looks kind of nice. Yeah, nice. I wish every car had some kind of description anywhere written, like how many cylinders and so on. Yeah, Corvette, that's a Corvette. 1, 2, 3, I believe that's a V8. Yeah, looks like it. Again, convertible, manual, most likely. All right, I think we have seen enough cars. Now let me try and get back to my friends. Look at that. Some more oldies to enjoy. Firebird. Mercury 11-4. Two-seater. this one is a bit, and notice that there are no seat, on most of them I haven't seen any seat belt. This one has. So way back they did not have any compulsory seat belt requirements. And look at that. This one is a smaller one. Anyways, looks good. I think I missed this one. Look at that. Ford. Nice. You even have a storage for space. Nice. Like it.
Thank you.
How many, Lilia? Look at that. We have so many ducks and albatrosses. Looks like they don't fear any humans because they are not threatened, but they leave a lot of shit here. That's one of the downsides. Nice pond. I'm still looking for my friends. Nowhere inside. A little waterfall here. Gazebo. Looks kind of nice. And where did my friends go? Okay, I'll have to keep a watch. They told me they are going to be around somewhere over here, but I can't see them anymore here. Maybe over there. The gazebo? No, not here either. Okay, let me search for them. Look, in the background, people are having fun with their little boats. Okay, this is my friend. He came all the way from Toronto to visit me. He loves Barrie downtown very much. We are enjoying here sunshine and everything, and it's a beautiful July weather. And so he came with his wife and kids, but my wife and kids are a bit camera shy, so I won't be taking that. But as you can see, we are right at the lakeshore and it's looking quite good. Okay, we're having our breakfast at the Williams Cafe. That would be the cafe name. And you know, the prices are amazing and the food is excellent. So we are having our breakfast right now. It's quite good. Love it. And so there are multiple chains. So if anyone prefers, they can have their. Okay. And this is my friend cooking mutton biryani. What are you making?
Mutton
kadai. Mutton kadai. Yeah, not biryani. Sorry. Okay, mutton kadai. And it looks really good. Also, nice smell coming from here. Good. Thank you so much.